think I used some strange things to make an art attack. The meat Anthony Haywood. Noticed when you've finished a drawing of a face and you come to paint it, there's never quite the right skin tone in your paint box. Well, I suppose you could always leave your drawing white. Let's try that. White? Nah, white isn't quite right. Okay, well, I suppose the next best thing is pink. So that's a little bit of red mixed in with the white. There's some red in there. Try that. It in, get a nice pinky colour there. Try it on the drawing. Alright, there we go. Red and white, pink. Oh no, this isn't going to be right, is it? Oh no, I'm not even going to bother with that. It looks like he's got a bad suntan. Let me just test it out here. No, red and white isn't quite right. There's one colour still missing. Yellow. Try it yourself. Mix it yourself. Next time you want to do some skin, red, yellow, and white. Just get himself a bit of yellow there. Put that down there. Mix it all together. This is the bit I like doing. Just slopping all the colours in. Blending them in the middle, like that. And you can see it just forming there. Right, let's try this. Ah, now then. That looks a bit better to me. Let's paint it around the corner there. This fella's looking a lot happier if you ask me. Of course, if you want to get it darker, you just add a bit of black. If you want to get it lighter, just add a bit more white, just around the corner there so you can see the effect. There it is. I think he's looking a lot happier there. Spilled a bit on the bottom, not to worry. Just try it on myself. There it is. Next time you want to do some skin, try mixing it yourself. Little bit of red, little bit of yellow, and little bit of white. And just remember, red, yellow, and white is right.
It's the head again. So there you go then. That's how you make a decent flesh colour. Bit of red, bit of white, bit of yellow on your brush. Yeah, Fred, you look a bit peaky. Fancy a bit of colour on your cheeks? Listen, mate, I'll paint you. Well, help me out a bit. Move over.
This isn't easy, you know. I think I'll stick to drawing. Ah.
That's the head again. Cool, that's a great idea, isn't it, eh? Next time it snows, I'm going to do that. Throw on me coat, pull on me wellies, put on me gloves. And then get someone to carry me out there so I can watch.
My name is Joanne, and this is a picture of Still Life Pots and Pans. Hello, my name's Sarah. I like this picture because it's colourful and I like sticking the paper on it.
My name's Kim and I enjoyed doing this picture because you had to catch the light and the dark bits in it.
Greg from Cliffwoods Middle School there, using cut-out paper or cardboard to create a picture of something. Well, here's the something I want to create a picture of. There's the cardboard that I've cut out, but the clever thing they did was to look at the object to see where it catches the light and shade. So where is the light and shade? Okay, well look at the teapot here. We've got a nice big wedge of light just along here and a sort of half moon of light going over the tip. So, I've cut that out of card. I'll stick it on. Just right up in the top there to give it a nice highlight on the corner of the teapot. Okay, where is the shade? Well, if you look at the back of the teapot here, on the handle, you've got a line of shade coming right down. So, I've cut it out of cardboard. Let's stick it on. It's just a case of looking at your object and seeing where the light and shade is and drawing those shapes onto some paper or cardboard. Light card for the light shapes, dark card for the dark shapes. And then you cut them out and put them on your big cutout. Here we go. Right, let's see. Try it yourself. Cut out some card, look at your object, see where it catches the light and shade.